Philippine senator clashes with a former drug enforcement agent in a hearing on allegedly leaked documents linking President Marcos Jr. to drug use. The details from RG Cruz.
Ex-PDEA agent Jonathan Morales came face-to-face with Eric Santiago and Romeo Enriquez, who allegedly tried to keep him from testifying before the Senate on the allegedly leaked documents of the Philippine Drug Enforcement Agency. Santiago is a former National Police Commission agent, while Enriquez is an agent of the Department of Justice's Office of Cybercrime Investigation. Enriquez admits he gave Morales advice about testifying.
I immediately advised Morales not to participate on the issue, considering the current political situation confronting our country today, the impact of such revelation, and the possibility that it be used for political cause.
Morales and Senator Jingo Estrada had heated exchanges during the hearing due to questions about Morales' credibility and the authenticity of the footage he submitted.
How can we be sure if the video that is going to be presented before the committee is totally unedited?
We will
knowing this person who has a lot of criminal records.
Parang hindi naman po sa maganda yung sinasabi ni ano no ni Senator Jingoy Estrada patungkol sa akin. Para namang ako talaga ang hinuhusugahan ako'y may kaso pa lang at hindi pa napapatunayan sa hukuman. Hindi kagaya po ang ating butihing senador.
No,
eh wag naman po.
Alam mo, Mr. Morales, please. Huwag mo pakikalaman yung kaso ko. Problema ko yon yung makaso mo ang ayusin mo.
Morales pushed back after Estrada brought up the ruling of the Civil Service Commission and the Supreme Court that found him guilty of dishonesty, grave misconduct, and conduct prejudicial over a case.
The Civil Service Commission ruled that, and I quote, "It is undeniable, based on Morales' admission, that he concealed or distorted the truth about factual circumstance of the arrest." Doon po sa kaso na yun, ikaw mismo ang umamin na you have planted evidence. Paano ka naman ngayon paniniwalaan sa mga sinasabi mo?
Hindi ako akusado, Mr. Chairman, para itest yung aking credibility. Kung ito, dinadanas ko ngayon na talagang sinisira yung aking pagkatao, hindi kaya ito ay may kinalaman doon sa ngayon presidente ng Pilipinas na naroon mismo doon sa dokumento na nagkataon na ako ay nag-imbestiga noong 2012.
The hearing went on to discuss the 2021 drug test of then-former Senator Ferdinand Marcos Jr., which lasted less than 5 minutes because that was the capacity of the test kit. It was also limited to cocaine, for which he tested negative. A former palace official explained why they met with Morales. Morales had claimed it was an effort to stop his investigation.
Because the premise of this question, Mr. Chairman, Attorney Lacanilaw, is ang pinapalabas ni Ginoong Morales kasi pinigilan daw yung investigasyon niya mula sa taas mismo yung utos at bilang patunay nun at ebidensya nun, pinatawag nga daw siya sa Malacanang.
It's about his mga reklamo niya na inilipad siya from a big operation to community operations, I think sa Payatas, at ini-imply niya na hawak ng sindikato yung PDEA leadership kaya ginawa yon. So yun ang lumalabas sa media. Hindi ko po naririnig yung Rockwell. Wala pong kinalaman dun yun. Kaya po pinatawag namin just because of that claim. Your Honor,
if I the PDEA meanwhile explained point by point why the allegedly leaked documents were spurious. One
thing, Your Honor, they do not exist in the PDEA blatter book ng aming plans and operation service from 2010 up to present. Lahat po ng anti-illegal drugs operations and coordination na ginagawa, aside from yung amin pong database, meron po kaming blatter book. The name Bongbong Marcos alias Bonget does not appear in the National Drug Information System or Interagency Drug Information Database. Hence, he has never been included in the drug list or been subjected to any negation operation.
Senators again urged caution in the conduct of the hearing. Zubiri admits he's getting flack from all sides because of the hearings.
Galit sa akin yung Duterte Group dahil nagpalabas po tayo ng warrant of arrest against Pastor Kibuloy. Tapos, galit din yung Marcos Group sa akin, yung mga loyalists, dahil daw pinayagan kita mag-hearing na yung araw na ito at nung nakarang ilang dalawang linggo.
Meanwhile, the committee has received the deed of sale of the condo unit in Makati City sold by Diamond Star Maricel Soriano in August 2012. De La Rosa notes Soriano still owned it at the time of the information referenced in the leaked PIDEA document. The hearing also established there's no specific law penalizing the leak of secret documents. There's still another hearing set for next week. Former Executive Secretary Paquito Ochoa skipped Monday's hearing, claiming he has COVID-19. RG Cruz, ABS-CBN News.